I joined this company in 2006. I can easily count as high as 10 acquisitions we did between 2006. When we took over this function 2 years back, we have almost evaluated 17 deals and only two actually like reached the final stages. Just to give a backdrop, I don't know how many are from pharma industry. The industry is a little bit unique. I think when you talk about a strategic initiative, you talk about a business development. It could start from an in-licensing, out-licensing, alliance, co-development, external R&D, joint venture, and there are so many aspects in a pharma space. You could actually like say, look, what is so complicated between, or what is the interlinkage between all these various approaches one could take while you talk about a business development. We have come across situations even an in-licensing could lead to an M&D. Or you actually have a strategic alliance with somebody and some stage you could actually say, like, why not we actually buy out the guy? So there are lots of opportunities, or you could also get into, like, you have a contract manufacturing and over a period of time you could actually start looking out, taking a small equity stake or getting into having some sort of a minority control. So I actually find it really difficult where to draw a line for an M&A and various other business development activities, because it's a little bit interlinked. So our role is to have a little bit of a open ears to the entire organization, what's happening, whichever geography we are actually getting into. So the life becomes a little bit challenging as well as interesting. Whatever we have done is basically to improve our capability. It could be in the form of a technology, it could be in the form of getting into a new geography, getting into certain people competency. So that's what we were all looking at. I think we have not gone into a disruptive stage of getting into a new business like an auto or getting into some other pharmaceutical chain, things like that. We are restricting ourselves to the core business of generic formulation business, and we have actually not gone out of that. Maybe here I just wanted to pick up something from a book called Profit from Core. I think this is written by Chris Zook. He has talked about adjacencies, like you actually have multiple dimensions of a business. You could talk about a geography, you could talk about a technology, you could talk about various businesses, regions, the distribution model, things like that. In fact, I tried to map how Dr. Reddy's would fit into, if I were to do an adjacency map for Dr. Reddy's. We are actually just in oral solids. We are just trying to get into injectables. So if you see the vertical of a drug delivery, you have opportunities of getting into like patches or various other form of delivery system using any apparatus like a respiratory. You need a small apparatus to actually like use your drug. So the opportunities, if I look at it on a delivery system, there are phenomenal. If I actually go into a technology side, I think there are phenomenal opportunities. Actually, we are actually restricting ourselves only to few technologies. So like if I look at M&A scope, I can actually like get into where the gaps are in terms of technology and how do we actually fill it up. So today, like you could actually talk about, or if you go to the molecule side, we are either in small molecules or we are just getting into monoclonal antibodies. You have things like peptides, we have actually not experimented. So like you don't need to go outside the scope of your own business. If you try to understand what is the gap you have within your own business, I think you will see enormous scope even in the business where you are operating in. We looked at geographies. I think at some stage we went, I think we were selling almost to 30 to 40 geographies worldwide. Then we realized it doesn't make sense to have so many geographies. In pharmaceutical, as you are aware, creating the formulation for geographic specific packaging or a formulation is fairly complicated. We actually exited out of 30 geographies because it was actually adding more complexities to your own operations rather than actually like trying to improve your top line or bottom line. This decision we took a couple of years back. Now, let me just straight away go into some of the key learnings what we learned in the last 5-6 years in M&A. I'll just take it on. Subsequent to this, you have a nice session by the law firms from Netherlands. So maybe I will actually take the financing part first and a little bit on the operation part second. I think the learnings what we got in Beta Farm is more on structuring, financing, and tax. I think I was actually handling the financing of Bida Farm. One of the biggest tasks is to raise 400 million euro at that point of time.